When closing a gap, the flow in the gap will increase, and this will lead to an increase in the velocity. In case of a sandy bottom, this increase in velocity will result in scour. Scour as such is not a problem. But when the scour hole comes too near to the structure, there is the risk that the structure slides down into the scour hole. Therefore, a bed protection is needed. So the main purpose of a bed protection is to keep the scour hole sufficiently far away from the structure. The flow over the sill has a high velocity and is very turbulent. This causes the scour hole. When the depth of the hole is known and the stable slope for the subsoil is also known, one can calculate the required length for bed protection. For normal sand, the cotangent of the equilibrium slope is in the order of 6. For loosely packed sand, subject to liquefaction, it might be in the order of 15 to 20. In case of normally packed sand, for movement of grains has to be moved far away from each other. So there has to be an inflow of water. The friction between the grains is relevant. In case of loosely packed sand, case B, the sand will become more densely packed after the movement. So the water has to be pressed out of the sand body, because that friction between the grains decreases. There is an increase of the pore pressure and a decrease of the pressure between the grains. This transforms the sand into a mass of what could be called thick water. This is liquefaction. And this starts to flow and creates a flow slide. In that case, the final slope is on the average 1 in 15, but it can be much flatter in some cases. In some observed flow slides, the final slope was only 1 in 100. At the landward edge of the slide, there is usually a steep section. For safe calculations, usually the steep part is neglected. It is necessary to calculate the depth of a scour hole in order to determine the required length. Because usually a closure has a limited duration, it is not necessary to determine the equilibrium depth of the hole, but the depth at a certain time. For this purpose, one can use the Breuser's formula. This formula gives the scour depth as a function of time and current velocity. The critical velocity can be calculated with the Shields formula. The velocity at the end of the bed protection is calculated from the velocity in the closure gap, and then is introduced for a flow expansion over the bed protection. The dustbin parameter alpha contains additional effect of turbulence. This dustbin parameter is a function of the length of the bed protection as shown in this figure. One can also calculate alpha using this formula. But in the determination of R0 using the Hofmanns and Hinze methods, it includes quite some uncertainties. Therefore, in practice, using the graph usually results in quite acceptable values for alpha. In reality, the flow velocity is not constant, but it varies with the tide. In the top figure, you see the water level variation at the seaside and inside. This results in a more or less sinusoidal velocity distribution of the velocity. But relevant is the value of alpha u minus u critical. And we have to raise this to the power 1.7. This means you have to integrate this value over time. Simply adding up the values is not possible, because during a closure, the maximum velocity changes. It increases usually because of the decrease of the gap. For each stage of the closure, you can determine the velocity, and for each velocity, you can determine an erosion line. These are the lines 1 to 4 in this graph, in graph B. Notice that line 4 is a little bit lower than line 3. In this example, this is caused by the fact that after stage 3 of the closure, the velocity decreases again. In the first 100 days, we have a low maximum current. At the end of that period, we have some 5 meters erosion. Then the current increases and we have to follow line 2. However, we should not start at 0 meters, because we have already 5 meters of erosion. So we start as a fictive value of 15 days. We have, during stage 2, 35 days. This means that we have at the end a fictive day of 50. At that moment, we have an erosion of 8.5 meters. Then we start stage 3. A depth of 8.5 meters has a fictive start value of 12 days. Stage 3 lasts for 20 days, so a fictive end at 32 days, and a scouring depth of 15 meters. In the last phase, we go for 10 days to stage 4. Velocity is less, line 4 is lower. The fictive starting point is at 80 days. So for the final closure is at fictive day 90. This means that in the last stage, we will not have much scour. So the final scour depth after the full closure of 100 plus 35 plus 20 plus 10 is 165 days. Bed protection can be made as a mattress or as loose material. Nowadays, usually a layer of loose rock is dumped on the bed using side stone dumpers. The top layer has to be sufficiently large to withstand the currents. However, these currents are usually too large to be placed directly on the sand bed. In that case, some intermediate layers are needed. For the determination of the grain size of the intermediate layers, one should follow the rules for the geometrically closed filters or design the filter as an open filter. The design of filters is outside the scope of this course. For details on filter design is referred to the rock manual. Instead of loose rock, also a mattress is possible. Here you see a very classical bed protection consisting of a fascine mattress. This mattress is ready to be sunken down in front of the discharge sluices in the Afsluitdijk, the closure dam in the north of the Netherlands. This is a picture from about 1930. For smaller projects with bed protections, they are still made in the same way. Nowadays, they consist of geotextile with fascines and the stones are placed by machines. Nowadays, the mattress is placed in position using a pontoon and one side is sunken down by using a sinking tube. This is a steel pipe connected to the mattress and it filters water. Then the side stone dumper is covering the mattress with armor stone.